Good afternoon, one and all. This is Dr. H. Ketan Krishna, professor from EC department. Now I am going to deal the topic is Maxwell's equations. These are one of the important topics in the electromagnetic fields and wave subject. Why? Because these Maxwell's equations only the important one, and from these Maxwell's equations only we have to derive the whatever the wave equations of EM waves, and that application of that EM waves are the antennas and whatever the communication, wireless communication is there, that all are there by using this Maxwell's equation. This Maxwell's equation also we have the format form in static fields as well as time wave. Means static fields means the stationary fields are there, and time varying fields mean with respect to time the field should be the change. Here whatever the Maxwell's equations are there, the Maxwell's equations in electrostatic fields are there and magnetostatic fields are there, same as the time varying field also electric field and magnetic field, Maxwell's equations are there. First one, we can take the Maxwell's equations for static fields. Maxwell's equations for static fields, which where is the Maxwell's equation, why the equation is called as a Maxwell's equation, what are the derivations of this Maxwell's equation, now we are going to discuss. Now the first Maxwell's equation is a static fields for electrostatic fields. The first Maxwell's equation is a delta D equal to rho V. This Maxwell's equation, this is a differential form. And integration form is this is the integration form. This Maxwell's equation comes from Gauss law. This is the integral form, and this is the here the first Maxwell's equation is the delta D equal to rho V, and integral form is D dot ds is equal to rho V dV, and this is from Maxwell's equation derived from the Gauss law. Now what is the Gauss law? Gauss law states that psi is equal to Q enclosed. What is the psi means? Here the total flux enclosed by the surface, total flux enclosed by the surface in electric field, that is equal to total charge enclosed by the surface. Total charge enclosed by the surface. Now what is this psi? This psi is equal to integral D dot ds. What is this? D means electric flux density. The total flux we can call as a whatever the flux density along the surface is called as a total flux. Here the flux density dot ds is equal to psi. Now psi is equal to integral D dot ds. D is the flux density within the surface area, whatever the total flux is there, that is equal to charge enclosed by that particular surface, that Q enclosed by the surface. This Q enclosed by the surface we can write as a rho V into dV along the volume. Here this is a closed surface and open this value. Now from these equations we can write as an integral D dot ds is equal to integral rho V and dV. Rho V dV. From the divergence theorem, this integral D dot ds we can write as an integral delta D into dV. Delta D. What is the divergence theorem? The divergence theorem tells that any vector within the closed surface, any vector in the closed surface equal to divergence of that vector in a particular value. Divergence of any vector in a particular value. That is tells us the divergence theorem. From the divergence theorem we can write as a delta D is equal to D. Now here the volume integral is there, here also volume integral is there. From these two equations we can write as a delta D equal to rho. This meaning is divergence of the electric flux density. Divergence of the electric flux density equal to volume charge density. Divergence of the electric flux density equal to volume charge density. This is a first Maxwell's equation for electrostatic field. First Maxwell's equation from the electrostatic field. This equation comes from the Gauss law. This Gauss law states that psi is equal to Q enclosed by the surface. Means whatever the electric flux enclosed by the surface equal to charge enclosed by the particular surface. From this equation, we can derive that delta D equal to rho V. This is the first Maxwell's equation, comes from the Gauss law. Next, second Maxwell's equation for electrostatic field, del cross E equal to 0. Del cross E equal to 0. This is equal to E dot dl equal to 0. E dot dl is equal to 0. This is comes from the potential. Here, why this value equal to 0 means, here comes from the potential. The potential V equal to integral E dot dl. This is a potential, we can call electric field intensity. E is the electric field intensity. Closed line along this line, E dot dl is equal to along the line electric flux density, electric field intensity we can call as a electric potential. From this, any closed loop we can take. If any closed loop we can take, the total potential value should be equal to 0. That's why this E dot dl is equal to any closed line. This E dot dl is equal to 0. From the Stokes theorem, this E dot dl we can write as a del cross E dot ds. Means from the Stokes theorem, line integral of electric field, line integral of any vector, equal to curl of that vector along the surface. That is comes from the Stokes theorem. Here from E dot dl is equal to 0. That's why del cross E also equal to del cross E dot ds is also equal to 0. From these two we can write as a del cross E equal to 0. This is the differential form. And this is the integral form. This is comes from the potential. The potential V is equal to integral E dot dl. From the closed loop, the potential should be equal to 0. That's why E dot dl is equal to 0. If E dot dl is equal to 0 means, here for the line integral of E, line integral of any vector, we can write in the curl of that vector in surface area. That's why E dot dl becomes as a del cross E dot ds. From these two equations, we can write as a del cross E equal to 0. This is the second Maxwell's equation from electrostatic field. Next, third one, the third equation. Del cross H is equal to J. I enclosed by the surface J dot ds. This is comes from the Ampere's third Maxwell's equation is del cross H is equal to J. J is the current density and H is the magnetic field intensity. This equation from magnetostatic fields, the first Maxwell's equation in magnetostatic field, or third equation of the Maxwell's equation, del cross H is equal to J. This equal to, this is a differential form and this is the integral form. Integral H dot dl is equal to I enclosed by the surface and J dot ds. This is comes from the Ampere circuit law. H dot dl is equal to I enclosed by the surface. From this equation, Ampere circuit law states that magnetic field intensity any closed line, that is equal to current enclosed by the surface. This is the Ampere circuit from. Ampere circuit. From this equation we can write as a I enclosed by the surface we can write as a J dot ds. Means J is the current density along the surface. That is called as a I enclosed by the surface. From this equation we can write as a J dot ds equal to H dot dl. Already I told that from the Stokes theorem this H dot dl we can write as a del cross H into ds. Del cross H into ds. Why? Because whatever the closure line along the line whatever the vector is there that we can write along the curl in the surface. That is the Stokes theorem. That is H dot dl we can write as a del cross H into ds. Means from these two equations, from these two equations we can write as a del cross H is equal to J. Del cross H is equal to J. This is the differential form. H dot dl equal to I enclosed by the surface equal to J dot dl. This is the Ampere's circuit law. Ampere's circuit law. This is the third Maxwell's equation or second Maxwell's, first Maxwell's equation of the magnetostatic fields. Magnetostatic fields. The fourth equation is del dot B equal to 0. Means integral B dot ds equal to 0. Integral B dot ds is equal to 0. This is from the magnetic flux. Magnetic flux. Here magnetic flux, that all other whatever magnetic flux are there, that magnetic flux are the closure line. Magnetic flux are the closure line from north pole to south pole or south pole to north pole. This all are the closure line. That's why whatever total flux we can calculate means this is a positive side and this is a negative side. That's why the total magnetic flux should be equal to zero and there is no isolated, there is no separation of this north and south poles in the magnetic field. That's why the total magnetic flux equal to zero along the surface. That's why that B dot ds is equal to along the surface magnetic flux density equal to zero along the surface B dot ds is equal to zero. Now in B dot ds we can apply the divergence theorem. Divergence theorem, this B dot ds we can write as a del dot B into dv along the value. That's why we can compare these two equations. There we can get del dot B equal to zero. Means divergence of the magnetic flux density equal to 0 along the value del dot B equal to 0. This is a magnetic flux. This is a Maxwell's equations for static fields. Magnetic Maxwell's equations for the static fields. The four Maxwell's equations are there. These four Maxwell's equations are very very important for the EMFW subject, electromagnetic fields, right? Where is these four Maxwell's equations? First equation from the Gauss law. From the Gauss law, Gauss law states that psi is equal to Q enclosed by the surface. Psi is a electric flux. Total electric flux in a closed surface that is equal to charge enclosed by the surface. And next one is the electric potential. From this potential, we can derive the del cross E is equal to 0. Why this del cross E is equal to 0? Means integral del dot E dot dl is equal to 0 along the closed line. The total potential should be equal to 0. That's why E dot dl is equal to 0. From this E dot dl equal to 0, we can apply the Stokes theorem. There we can get the del cross E dot dl becomes as a del cross E dot ds. Next, third Maxwell's equation, del cross H is equal to J. This is from the Ampere's circuit law. This Ampere's circuit law is the same as a Gauss law in magnetic field. Gauss law in magnetostatic field. That's why H integral H dot dl is equal to I enclosed by the surface. Integral I H dot dl is equal to I enclosed by the surface. This is the Ampere circuit law. Next, total magnetic flux density, divergence of the magnetic flux density equal to 0 or integral closed surface B dot ds is equal to 0. Why? Because the magnetic flux are the closed surface, closed lines. The magnetic flux are the closed lines along the surface. There is no any isolated poles are there, that's why the B dot ds should be equal to 0. Total magnetic flux along the surface is equal to 0. These are the four Maxwell's equations. Very, very important in the EMFW subject. Thank you.